Number 5.
Daybreakers is a 2009 science fiction thriller film, co-directed by Michael Spierig and Peter Spierig. Set in a future world, the majority of the Earth's population has been infected by a virus known as vampirus, turning them into vampires. As vampires rely on humans as a food source, the human population dwindles rapidly, creating a crisis for the vampire society facing a shortage of blood. The main character is Edward Dalton, played by Ethan Hawke, a rebellious vampire who joins forces with a group of human resistance fighters. Their goal is to find a cure for the vampire virus to save humanity. In the process, they discover a potential solution, but must contend with strong resistance from the vampire society. The film explores themes of resource depletion, survival, and the complex relationship between vampires and humans.
We need your help.
We want to rebuild the human race.
A blood substitute is not a cure.
I was like you once,
and not no more.
Who are you?
We're the folks with the crossbows.
That last breath of humanity
will vanish as soon as the blood does.
I found a cure. I can change you back.
What's the cure?
I'm already dead.
It doesn't hurt me.
Can anyone hear me? They found us. They're everywhere.
You wanna know that it doesn't
matter.
Number 4.
Only Lovers Left Alive is a 2013 fantasy romance film directed by Jim Jarmusch. Set in contemporary Detroit, the story revolves around a vampire couple, Adam and Eve, who lead a discreet existence in the human world. Adam, played by Tom Hiddleston, is a musician with a significant influence in the underground music scene, while Eve, played by Tilda Swinton, is a literature-loving vampire. Their lives revolve around music, literature, and engaging in unique artistic activities. With Ava's, played by Mia Wasikowska, rival, her actions gradually reveal internal issues within the vampire family. The story delves into Adam and Eve's past, their interactions with humans, and paints a picture of vampire society, exploring themes of the cost of eternal life and the loneliness that accompanies it.
Here to Detroit, is that correct?
I love what you've done with the place.
Remember when you gave that string quintet to Schubert?
I only gave him the adagio.
I had a dream about your sister.
Shouldn't she be sleeping in a coffin somewhere anyway? Probably with a wooden stake shoved in.
I'm really, really hungry. Do you maybe have something?
Could you smell it all the way from LA?
It's always a bit weird with family.
You're looking awfully pale there, Dr. Caligari.
Is that the really good stuff?
Precisely.
You've been pretty lucky in love, though, if I may say so.
God, I wish that I'd met him before I wrote Hamlet.
Whoa, man.
That certainly was visual.
What is that?
Oh, negative.
Number 3.
Let the Right One In is a 2008 Swedish horror romance film directed by Thomas Alfredson, adapted from John Edvard Lindqvist's novel of the same name. The story is set in 1980s Sweden and revolves around a lonely 12-year-old boy named Oscar, who is bullied by his classmates. One day, a seemingly 12-year-old girl named Eli, who is actually a centuries-old vampire, moves into the apartment building where Oscar lives. They form a peculiar and special friendship, and Oscar gradually discovers Ellie's true identity. The film blends horror elements with romantic emotions, portraying a unique and heartwarming connection between the two protagonists.
Är du vampyr?
Hade du tyckt om mig ändå?
Vill du bli ihop med mig?
Number 2.
Underworld is a 2003 action thriller film directed by Len Wiseman. The story is set in a modern city and revolves around the ancient feud and war between vampires and werewolves. The narrative follows Celine, a skilled vampire warrior played by Kate Beckinsale. She is assigned to participate in the centuries-long conflict between vampire clans and the werewolf species in this realm of deep-seated animosity. Celine finds herself entangled in an ancient conspiracy that has the potential to alter the history of vampires and werewolves. Throughout the story, Celine encounters a human doctor named Michael, played by Scott Speedman, who becomes unwittingly involved in the conflict between vampires and werewolves. As Celine and Michael join forces to confront enemies from both clans, they uncover a secret that could reshape the future of both species.
Who are you people?
You're in the middle of a war that's been raging for the better part of 1,000 years. A blood feud between vampires and lycans. Werewolves.
Now, a decision must be made.
Why did you bring him here?
You saved my life.
Between an oath sworn centuries ago.
A human. He's not a human at all. He's a lycan.
And a power.
There can be no such union.
Greater than vengeance.
You'll be lucky if I can convince the council to spare your life.
Absolution will be yours the moment you kill Michael.
Number 1.
Interview with the Vampire is a 1994 horror drama film directed by Neil Jordan. The movie explores the immortal and lonely existence of vampires, with the main focus on a young gentleman named Louis, played by Brad Pitt, who becomes a vampire in 18th century Louisiana. His transformation is guided by another powerful vampire, Lestat, played by Tom Cruise. And their unique mentor-disciple relationship becomes the central theme of the story. Throughout the narrative, Louis recounts his experiences with other vampires, including the complex love affair with another vampire woman, Claudia, played by Kirsten Dunst. The film delves into the intricacies of vampire survival, their emotions, and the struggles that come with eternal life. Louis shares his story with a journalist, played by Christian Slater, providing a modern perspective on the vampire existence. The film also explores the complex relationships and emotions among the vampires, adding depth to the narrative.
This is the only real evil left.
And then he took the light of day.
You're a vampire. You never knew what life was until it ran out in a red gush over your lips. I can't stand this any longer.
You made us what we are, didn't you?
God kills indiscriminately, and so shall we.
You like dying? You condemn me to hell!
Monster. One happy family.
Hatred we. Her suffering and yours! So do not doubt! You are a killer!
Tom Cruise, Brad Pitt, Stephen Ray, Antonio Banderas, Kirsten Dunst, and Christian Slater. Interview with the Vampire.